If you're an individual or an organization that holds DOT tokens and would like to give some, but not all, access to your account to other individuals or organizations, proxy accounts are for you. Proxy accounts are natively supported on both Polkadot and Kusama network, powered by Substrate code and cryptography. Let's say you created a staking proxy account. This staking proxy account can control all of your account's staking related transactions, like nominating a new set of validators, bonding and unbonding tokens, etc. But the important thing is it can't move funds from your account. Okay, so it can't do any other transactions that are not part of the staking process on the network. Similarly, a governance proxy can participate on on-chain governance on your behalf, but you know, it can't do anything else with your account. A non-transfer proxy, like the name suggests, can do all the transactions with your account except for balance transfers. Okay, so in the end, you hold all of your DOTs in your account when you use any of these proxies. All right, so here is the list of proxy accounts supported on Polkadot and Kusama at the time of making this video. For a detailed explanation of what these proxy accounts are, check out our wiki documentation. Now, let's see how to add a proxy to your account. You can navigate to the developer tab on Polkadot.js apps UI, go to extrinsics, select proxy palette from the dropdown, and select add proxy. Here, you're provided an option to select the proxy account and its type from the dropdown. Setting up a proxy account requires a base deposit of around 20 DOT and a deposit factor of 0.03 DOT per proxy. You will get these deposits back once you decide to remove all these proxies. All right, we recommend that you first try out features like these on Westend, which is Polkadot's test network. You can get Westies, which are like Westend native tokens, for free through a faucet. Anyways, so let me demonstrate how to set up a staking proxy for an account on Westend and show how that proxy account can sign transactions on behalf of your account. All right, let me click on the developer tab and extrinsics. So here, I'm going to select the proxy palette. Okay, so in the dropdown, click on proxy palette. I'm going to add a new proxy here. That would be my proxy account, which would be a staking proxy. And the delay is zero. So I'm going to sign and submit this transaction. So once I sign this transaction, the staking proxy is set up for my Westend account right there. To verify that, go to accounts tab, and then here for the Westend account, you see that some amount of Westies are reserved, and here there's an option to see the proxy overview. There you go. So you have a staking proxy that is set up. If you'd like to clear all of your proxies, you have an option right there. All right, so let's do some staking with this staking proxy. So let me navigate to network and staking, go to accounts tab there, and set up a nominator account. Okay, so the Westend account, I'm going to bond some tokens right there. Let me click on next button right here. And then I'm going to pick a bunch of validators to nominate. And yeah, so here is where you see that the UI is presenting us with the staking proxy account. Use a proxy for this call. So let's sign and submit. So we are signing with the proxy, right? So W3F account was a staking proxy account. So once I sign this transaction, I'm setting up a nominator for the Westend account. Okay, so that was the original account. There you go. So now we successfully set up, a nominator with the Westend account just by using a staking proxy. You could also, issue other staking transactions using the same staking proxy account.